Hello everybody, in this video a closer look at one of Beuker's high-end folders. This is the Beuker Titan Defender Lightweight. A bit of background before I explain this knife, well, examine this knife in more detail. So, already a few years ago, Beuker launched this knife. That is the Beuker Titan Defender with a G10 handle here and a full titanium liners and titanium bolsters as well. This knife was designed by Armin Stutz, an Austrian custom knife designer who wanted to make a really capable, really sturdy, modern tactical design. This one here, that's the one that we will discuss now, is the lightweight version. And, well, lightweight is a bit a strong term, but it's indeed lighter than the other one because it doesn't have the extra bolster, and perhaps because the canvas micarta might be just a bit lighter than the G10. Now, I'm not certain about the density of each of them. I also think that the lightweight, which is quite a bit cheaper by the way, also looks even better, while this one is really nice in reality. I like here that the lightweight, as we will see, has a stone washed blade. Now, so these two are the tactical ones, but these are not the only ones which Beuker launched since a few years already. Two years or so. Wait a minute. I'm trying to get, well, let's do it that way. Also here are the two Hunter variants. With Kronidur steel, which I discussed actually in this more classic knife. Kronidur is that space age steel that doesn't rust, a kind of an similar to H1 of Spyderco, because it replaces carbon with nitrogen, allowing for very fine edges, reasonable edge holding, probably around 440C or so. And absolutely resistance to rust. So that is the steel that they used in these other two variants, with you could say a somewhat nicer blade form, without a switch, without thumb studs. These are two hand opening knives, but you can see the general look is quite similar. On the end there of the handle is a bit different, but it's really quite a similar knife also when you inspect them from close by. This is one with stack and here one with wood. And then there is also another nice one. That is here the Titan Worker, another two-hand opening knife, very nice in practice, with a 440C steel. And here some canvas micarta, which looks browner on the photo than in reality, and Titan bolsters. This one cost more or less, well, almost the price of the one that I'm discussing. While I'm not really looking for tactical designs in general, I still thought that the one that I discuss is still a bit nicer than this Titan Worker. But this, just to show you that this is part of a family of knives of Beuker, the classic German company. While in the past many of the high-end folders were designed in the recent few years by Dietmar Pohl, but he is now doing his own knives. He makes his own knife company, I mean. It's good that there is still a lot of things happening in their world. Bon, I go back to the knife now, because I thought the background of Armin Stutz, the designer, making a full line actually of variants, is quite cool. Well, this is a very nice general utility folder. I'm not a perfect person to ask about tactical applications. I can only tell you that for general utility this is really cool. So 150 grams only, yeah, lightweight is a bit a strange expression in this context, but it is a really a nice handful. And it also, what I like about it, I like several things about it. The blade length is that nice mid-range length of 8,6 centimeter, which is, well, you could say it's around 3.5 inches. So it's nicely between the 3 and the 4 inches, which are a bit the typical typical medium and large blade size. This one in between is really nice. Still being N690BO, which that's a Böhler steel, an Austrian steel, and it's serialized, by the way, 114 here. So that's my well, I think that's a serial number on my blade. There is here a German text, Steyr Eisen. I don't know what it refers to, actually. I have no idea. Maybe somebody can tell me in the comments. Perhaps that is linked to the designer. 3.5 mm, pretty sturdy, the hands. And that stonewashed look is really nice. So N690 is less known by American knife maniacs, you could say. Well, this is N690BO. I don't know if it's really different from the normal N690, which is, from a composition point of view, quite similar to VG10. Hence, a pretty good steel, actually, really at the upper, maybe not the absolute top, but really upper mid-range. So I don't know really about this specific variant. I can look back to see if they say something about the Rockwell harness. I cannot immediately see it, something about the Rockwell harness. Suffice to say that in my experience, this blade steel is perfectly sufficient. It's really, really good. It also is pretty rust resistant. I think with all these so-called high-end steels, the way the heat treat is done, how careful that is done, has probably more an influence on the steel than that composition, because these days they're all really, really good. So what else? Well, okay, 8,6 cm by 3,5 mm, that's cool. Canvas micarta, which is really nice in the hand, has a very utilitarian look to it, but really nice. No jimping. But with this big choil, you could say, honestly, your fingers are perfectly, you will never lose the grip there. So I wouldn't worry about that. Usually, I'm often a bit afraid about knives that already foresee choils for your fingers. Because, well, if your hand isn't exactly, you could say, distributed your fingers, that the way that the designer plant, and which can be if your hands are singularly large or singularly small, then perhaps it doesn't fit very well. In this case, well, perhaps you have to try it for yourself. I think that most people will find this very nice. There is enough play here how to put your finger depending on your size, and here at the end there is it just a curve. What else? There is a glass breaker, should you care about that. Of course you need to have it with you in the car when you need to break the glass of your car, but okay. The clip, this is Bokeh's modern clip. I'm not certain if it's from titanium, the clip. I forgot to look that up. Maybe they say it also in the brochure. They don't say it. But so, I don't think it looks so nice with the Bokeh name cut out. But okay, and now it's also, you see the screws are inside the letters, the characters, so you can still get the clip off if you want. Now, why is this such an amazing knife? The handholding is cool. It's extremely sturdy, eh? And where is that sturdiness coming from? Well, these full titanium liners. These are, as also the liner lock itself, it's one of my sturdiest liner locking knives. They are 2.5 mm thick, meaning actually, many frame lock knives, if the frame is 2.5 to 3 mm usually, then the lock is not that much stronger than this liner lock of 2.5 mm. So it's a real, and then, like I say, full titanium, which is rust resistant itself. The handle contour follows perfectly the frame, the liners, so that's good. Here's a tiny bit of a jimped spacer here at the end, and it really exudes an enormous quality. Now, when we talk about high quality liner locking knives, very sturdy was my own reference is the Beastly ZT200. When it comes to an over-engineered, kind of very sturdy liner lock knife. Well, there's also the military, which I dearly love, but which really feels more like a scalpel. But when it comes to heavy duty utility, there is this one. And it's interesting to compare them. Look here at the bottom. You can see, while the ZT, everybody who held one knows that it's an absolute beast. Well, the liners of the Beuker are even a bit thicker. You see it straight away. It's even a bit sturdier, the feel. The Beuker is also quite a bit lighter than the ZT. Oh, and yeah, it's a bit smaller, the blade, but oh, does it matter so much? Probably not, to be honest. And I also like the fact that it doesn't have a recurve. The handholding of both is really good. So here, this deep, very deep coil of the ZT200 is of course enormously sturdy in the hand. But I cannot say that this is really worse. And it feels nimbler because it's lighter. Actually, I do prefer the Beuker. I think the ZT200 is a fantastic heavy duty knife. The Beuker, in my opinion, will be just as sturdy or even sturdier. Definitely not less sturdy. And it actually, yeah, is because of the weight, it's more pleasurable to carry and to use. So, well, really nothing, not to diminish the ZT200, eh, which is really good. Because by American standards, of course, the big disadvantage of the German-made Beukers, as opposed to the Korean or China made, is or Taiwan made, is simply the fact that the European cost of labor makes this a pretty expensive knife in America. I noticed that there were a few online shops where you could find it at around $220. Which is well what we have then in America for that price. Well, maybe the Bradley Alias could be an interesting comparison, which is a frame lock, but look here at the sturdiness. With this kind of sturdiness, you don't really have to worry about liner lock of frame lock, in my opinion. Or by the European price, if you what you also often find is a price quite similar to this one, the small Sebenza. Sebenza being, yeah, it's more precise than Sebenza. It's true that here, this one is also really, really good actually. I will tell you soon why, in which context the Beuker is a bit less precise in feel. But when it comes to high utility and performance, it shouldn't disappoint you. I just noticed here a lanyard jaw, but for this kind of large knife, I don't see really the point of attaching a lanyard as well. Another comparison here in length with the classic Victorinox Soldier. It's quite a different beast, obviously. The clip, it's pretty stiff, and your knife will also go quite deep in your pocket. There's not much sticking out there, but and you cannot place the clip anywhere else. I don't know. For me, it's not really an issue if you cannot put it somewhere else, but some people find that extremely important. So just so you know, and what you then see, it's indeed by default, well, and not always, it's a tip-up carry knife, if you close it. So about now the finish, in general it's really good. Now Beuker, or Beuker I should say, sometimes have a few less than perfect details. I noticed that already a few times. In this case, what you sometimes have is, when you open the blade really quick, I won't do it now, then the liner lock can engage so strongly that that is really difficult to disengage it. That's a bit annoying. I think it's a matter of really precise adjusting so that it doesn't happen anymore. Also out of the box, well, you see the tip could have been a bit more in the middle. It's only a millimeter or so, but I mean, for the price it could be. If this very cheap Sanremo can do it, why not the Boker, which is a multiple in cost. Also, well, I think here linked to this effect that it's just not exactly in the middle, and the fact that you can see it's a pretty tight fit here for the blade between the two liners. You actually feel the blade touching the liner a bit. Not that it's something to worry about, but I think if it would be just in the build, it would be okay. So what I will likely do is try to adjust the pivot a tiny bit to get it in the middle, and then see if I can also make the lock a bit more easy to disengage. Because honestly, well, let's see if I do it quicker. Yeah, that's what I mean. Now it's difficult to do it with one hand. Well, of course, the other side of the coin is here. You know that it's really, really, really very sturdy. The lock. So it's absolutely dependable. So in short, I would say this is a fantastic knife. Yeah, a few small details that I explained at the end, that is maybe a matter of adjustment. But in general, so extremely sturdy, and I think it also looks good. And well, 150 grams is not exactly light, but considering it's a heavy duty kind of folder, still pretty doable, especially compared to the ZT. An interesting mid-size blade length I mentioned. Stone-wise blade, you don't see that so often. It adds to the cost. This Canvas Micarta handle, which has a really good hand holding. The pride of ownership of enormously thick titanium liners. So it feels high-end. Actually, it feels really extremely sturdy and capable, which is what it is. So, I can recommend this knife. The more classic high-end Bokers are, for example, the Turbine. I think you say Turbine in English. The Eurofighter and a few others. They are all very, very nice. However, I think this is an example of the high-end Bokers of the future. Really sturdy, no-nonsense, and dependable. Check them out, I would say. Especially if you... So here, that's what I have again. The lock is really engaging extremely strongly if you open it too quick. If there is anybody who has a tip, by the way, what's the best way to do that? I thought, because I didn't think I need to open the whole knife, but just a bit with the pivot, if that helps, I think so. So maybe some people have more experience with that than I have, because I rarely need to do it. So feel free to leave feedback. Wonderful knife in my opinion, with small details which could be better.